Hello friends, I'm Divya and I'm back with another episode of Personalities. Today we're going to talk about Indulal Kanhaiyalal Yagnik. He was born on 22nd February 1892. So before I start, I would like to request you to subscribe Vaishya's channel and subscribe Vaish courses. Keep supporting us by liking these videos, sharing these videos as much as you can. Your likes and shares are a good inspiration for us so that we come up with such new initiatives. Also, if you want to buy test series or current affair package, you can contact the number given in the thumbnail. So without any further ado, let's get started. So Indulal Yagnik, who was he? He was an Indian independence activist. He purchased the Indian tricolor, which was hoisted by Madam Bhikaiji Kama. He brought it from Germany to India. He was the leader of All India Kisan Sabha, and he was the one who led Maha Gujarat movement. If you remember, from post-consolidation India, there was a demand for separate Gujarat state from the Bombay Residency, right? So he spearheaded the demand for separate statehood of Gujarat on 8 August 1956. He is also known as Indu Chacha. He was also a writer and a filmmaker. We'll know about his early life. He was born at Jhagadia Pole in Nadiad in Khed, which is in Gujarat. His father, Kanhaiyalal, died at a young age while studying, and he completed his primary and secondary education in Nadiad. After that, he went on to join Gujarat College, which is in Ahmedabad, where he did his BA degree, and later he joined St. Xavier's College in Mumbai, where he completed his LLB. Now we'll know about his contribution in independence movement. So as you can see, as I told earlier, Yagnik brought the tricolor flag from Stuttgart, Germany. It was hoisted by Madam Bhikaiji Kama. And he was deeply influenced by Annie Besant during his college days. He published an English language magazine called Young India, which you can see here, from Bombay in 1915. And he also started the publication of Gujarati monthly Navjeevan Ane Satya in 1915 itself. He was an editor of Young India, but later he handed over the editorship to Mahatma Gandhi in 1919, and that's how Mahatma Gandhiji was associated with Young India. Now we'll see in the chronological order how his activities were during the national independence struggle. Right? So here in 1917, as you can see, he joined the Servants of India Society. Then he later resigned. Right? And he joined Home Rule Movement. Right? Because he was influenced with Annie Besant. Then in 1918, as you can see, he participated in the Khed Satyagraha, and if you remember, it was led by Mahatma Gandhiji. Then in October 1922, he started Gujarati monthly Yug Dharma. After that, in April 1923 to March 1924, he was imprisoned by British from, as you can see, April 23, 1923 to March 1924. Later, from 1924 to 28, he was the editor of Hindustan. This was a Gujarat daily, which was from Bombay. And during 1926 to 27, he was also assistant editor of the Bombay Chronicle. It was a very famous newspaper then. Then 1936, his active initiation in the formation of All India Kisan Sabha. Right, and in 1939 he founded Gujarat Kisan Parishad. Right, then from 1940 to 1941 he was imprisoned again by British due to his anti-war campaign. Right, then in 1942 he presided over the annual session of Akhil Hind Kisan Sabha. Right, and then in 1943 he started the Gujarat daily called Nutan Gujarat in 1943. Now we'll know about his contribution post-independence. Okay, so in 1956 he led Maha Gujarat movement. Right, as I mentioned earlier, it is in post-consolidation of India. So there was after the formation of Andhra Pradesh, right, due to the agitation of Potti Sriramulu, there was demand for other states also, other statehood also, and Maha Gujarat movement was one of them, which demanded for separate Gujarat state. And he became the founder president of Maha Gujarat Janata Parishad in 1956. Then in 1957, he was elected to the second Lok Sabha from Ahmedabad constituency as a candidate of Maha Gujarat Janata Parishad. After the formation of Gujarat state on 1st May 1960, Maha Gujarat Jan Parishad was dissolved because its purpose was reached, right? Its target was reached. Then in June 1916, he founded Nutan Maha Gujarat Janata Parishad and he was re-elected to the 3rd Lok Sabha as its candidate, right, in 1962. So as you can see, this is the map of 1909. Of the Bombay Presidency. This is the northern part and you can see here the southern part of the Bombay Presidency back then, right? So he was involved in Maha Gujarat movement. You can see some of the pictures there. It involved mass agitation, protests, everything was peaceful and non-violent way. You can see some of his books here. He was, as mentioned earlier, he was a famous writer and he was also he wrote a novel, right? And he wanted to make a film on based on that, but which could not be done, right? And this novel was Maya. He wanted to make it into a film, but that could not be done. And here you can see this one, Life of Ranchhodh Das Bhavan Lotwala, and most of his works are influenced by Gandhiji, right? You can see here Peer Sabarmati. Gandhi as I knew him and when Gandhiji was in Yerwada jail, so his experiences was also written by Indulal Yagnik, right? And then Yagnik's most notable work was in Gujarat language, right? And his biographical work is Atmakatha, right? And also some of his more publications some magazines he was associated with were like Navjeevan, N.A. Satya, Yug Dharma, Young India, and some newspaper like Mumbai Samachar, Nutan Gujarat, right, Bombay Chronicle and Hindustan. And he also wrote some of the plays like Asha Nirasha, right, it was depicting the Bardoli Satyagraha, right, and you can see he also wrote some poetry and short notes, right. He died on 17 July 1972 at Ahmedabad, and in Ahmedabad there is a statue of his. So with this, we have come an end to this episode. So thank you so much for watching. Keep liking us and supporting us. Thank you so much.